In this video, I'd like to just start out by answering question number one on our sheet, which says, what is the difference between astronomy, astrophysics, astrology, and astronomology? So on the screen over here, I have them sort of labeled. I'll make a little bit of a table here. Let's just start then with astronomy. So an astronomy is very old. It's something like that goes back maybe 4,000 years originally to Arabian and Chinese cultures. And what astronomy was about was basically people were just sort of looking up at the dots in the sky, the little white dots that you see at night, which of course we know now are stars and planets. In addition to looking up at the dots, they would have also been looking up at the sun and the moon and just sort of the sky in general, maybe mostly the night sky, and just sort of wondered about the motion of those objects, tracking them, recording them. When is the moon going to rise? When is the sun going to rise? When are they going to set? When are we going to see a particular star? That kind of thing. And they actually got quite good at it. Historical records and doing it over and over again, maybe making etchings on bones, believe it or not, for the moon's motion. They were quite good at it. And it was a very developed science by the time. And that's sort of what astronomy is. So in a nutshell, astronomy, which is the title of this course, is about motion of the sky, in particular the things in the sky. But then what happened is that as technology got better, we can move over here to the astrophysics column, and we might start to ask more than the motion. We might start to ask things, physical things, about these objects. Like, for example, we might, instead of just looking at a dot in the sky, we might sort of wonder what the dot's color is or what its temperature is, like literally how hot it is. We might wonder how fast it might be moving. We might wonder what its size is or its mass, you know, that kind of thing. These physics things started to get in there, and that's where astrophysics started to come from, and it makes things a bit more interesting. So instead of just focusing on just motion of things, which is what astronomy is about, and this is an Astro 101 course, so maybe our whole course should be just about motion, but that's just a little bit boring. And so even in this class, we will do a bunch of we will let physics enter our discussion, so we can talk about some more interesting and stimulating things about things we see in the sky other than just their motion. The color, the temperature, the speed, the size, the mass, those are interesting things, and so those will creep into our discussion. But you see then, there is a difference then between straight-up astronomy and astrophysics. So let me just clean up the table just a tad bit here. Next we go into astrology here. And what astrology is about essentially here is, let's see, something like do life's events. Matter to what's in the sky. That's sort of in a nutshell what astrology is about. So by life events, definitely we're talking about, oh, I don't know, falling in love, being born, that kind of thing, life events. But would those things be linked to what's in the sky? Does it matter what's in the sky, say when you were born or when your child is born or when you met your significant other, that kind of thing? That's what astrology would be about. But the most important distinction about astrology here, it is not science. Okay, I think me personally, just I'm the speaker here, I'm not really that interested in astrology. I'm definitely going to leave it out of this class. So I put a little frown face there because I do want to stick to the science only in this Astronomy 101 class. But I just also want to make the note that I understand astrology and where its roots are, what its roots come from. So I'll talk about that a little bit. So there you go. We see the three differences between these things. To sort of start with astro, like that. Astronomy is about motion. Astrophysics is where we start to let some physics leak into the discussion on these objects that we see in the sky. Then, of course, astrology is not science, but it's this idea that maybe life's events have something to do with what's in the sky. So in the next video, I'll tell you a little bit more about astronomy and some of its origins.